Hey everyone, I'm going to try some new shit tonight, so I hope this works. But I do need one of these because, unfortunately, as you get older, you can't remember bugger all, you know what I mean? Some time ago, I went on a bus. And when you get older, you realise that you haven't done things for many, many years. And anyway, I got on this bus and I suddenly realised I didn't know what to do. Now, this may sound stupid, so I said to the driver, I haven't been on a bus for a long time, can you tell me what to do? So he said, yeah, well, okay mate, what you do, you stand there, you tell me where you want to go, I tell you how much, you give me the money, I give you a ticket, you go and sit down, I drive the bus, you ding the bell, then I stop the bus, then you get off. Simple as that. So I said, okay, right, let me get this straight. I stand here, I tell you where I want to go, you give me a ticket, I give you the money, I sit down, you drive the bus, I ding the bell, you stop the bus, and I get off. He said, yeah, that's about it. Now, where do you want to go? So I said, like a single stage. So he said, right, what you do then, mate, is ding the bell and get off. So why's that? Well, you're on the wrong fucking bus, you need a number 72. When I was very young, my parents were very religious, but you know, in those days, people didn't have cars, they went everywhere by bus. So everything either worked or failed according to the bus. My parents were going to have me christened, and unfortunately, on the day of the christening, would you believe it, the bus didn't come. So that was the end of that. A very good friend of mine is in a wheelchair, and I said to him, do you want to come out on the piss? He said, yeah, I'd love to. And he's a real great mate and really good fun. Do you know what? He didn't bloody stand up once all night and buy a bloody drink. The other thing is, he said to me, you're doing stand-up. I'd like to do some stand-up, Trevor. So I thought about it. I said, no, it's not possible. And he approved those jokes, by the way. I then saw an advert for stand-up comedian. So I went along and went into the interview room, and the guy said to me, we're looking for somebody that can handle a big part. So I said, okay. Yeah, we want somebody who can push things home when necessary, do a lot of stand-up throughout the act, withdraw, and without offending the ladies in particular. So I said, okay, that sounds good. And then they told me, actually, they were interviewing for a porn film, which was, they were looking for a stunt cock, not actually fuck that one up big time. But I have been in films in my life, and some of you will know that I have taken part in a couple of specialist films. The last episode, unfortunately, was cancelled because the bedroom door was just too small to get a horse in. Having said that, the good thing was that none of the actors actually got a part that night. So, and I had to go driving on the motorway recently, and I noticed everybody was bunching. And I thought, Jesus, what's going on here? So much bunching. Then I realised that there were florists going to a flower show. Bloody bunches. But as an older person, you know, you like to be a good citizen and drive carefully, and I'm a good driver. I always drive at 30 miles an hour and keep to the rules of the road. And, you know, 30 miles an hour seems quite fast to me, particularly in the right-hand lane of the motorway. And you also notice as you get older, a lot of people start waving to you. You haven't got a clue who they are, but they wave to you all the time. So that's pretty good. I went to the doctors, and he said, go behind the screen, take everything off, and I'll be in a minute. And he came in with the nurse. He said, nurse, look at this. I'm exactly the Charles Atlas of the aviation world, isn't it? And I was going to do an aviation medical. Following that, I failed the eye test. So the doctor said, look, you know, you need to pass through these lines, you know. So he came up to me and gave me his glasses and said, try these. I passed the test with flying colours. Pretty good. The same doctor, who I got to know quite well, discussed with me about my question about having the SNP. And some years later, he remembered this, and he was in the back of my airplane, and it was empty. He suddenly shot up the front and said, if you come down the back now, I can do the SNP. So I thought, I looked at him, I thought, oh, right. Now, this didn't feel right to me. I could just see the accident report. You know, the captain was found in the rear of the airplane with his trousers around his ankles, his legs wide open, and the doctor had his face firmly pushed into the pilot's thighs. I couldn't see that. It was working out very well. And then there was a time when I went out with a girl, and I got quite intimate. And she said, I quite like you, Trevor, but I really think you should wear something. Now, she'd already said that she thought I had a really nice helmet. So I put it on. And then she looked at me very strangely and said, I still think you should wear something. Thank you very much. That's it.